I'm Jeff Campbell from Pratt Miller.
I'm Andy Weyenberg with Miller Welders.
Today we're building a surge tank. The formed caps are 5052, and the body of the surge tank will be 6061. And then we have a little aluminum bungs that get welded to the top that are also 6061.
The filler metal we'll be using is going to be the 5356. It's compatible with both the 6061 body and the formed 5052 caps. Also, this tank has to go out and get anodized, and the 5356 filler metal gives us the proper color match.
Warning: read and follow all labels and the owner's manual.
For this project, we'll be using the Dynasty 400, setting the machine on AC, using 140 amps of average power, but we're also going to be splitting that amperage between electrode positive and electrode negative. We're going to be using 140 amps of electrode negative and 105 amps of electrode positive. Our balance setting is going to be 73, and our frequency is going to be 110.
When welding aluminum, metal prep is very important. You'd want to use a stainless steel brush or a file dedicated to aluminum to get rid of any impurities before you weld it. Now that I'm done welding the tank, I'm going to pressure test it and send it out to anodizing.
One of the things you may have noticed was that the pitch changed when he went to weld the fitting on the end cap. That's because we raised the frequency of the machine to give us a narrower weld bead. That helped the precision of his weld between the thicker fitting and the thinner end cap. For more information on the Dynasty 400, check out millerwelds.com.